is Hockey Week across America, and Sunday saw Team Canada take Game 3 of the Rivalry Series between the U.S. and the Canadians in Detroit. We're joined now by Megan Bozek, who played not only in that series, but who also plays for the CWHL's Markham Thunder. Megan, as we kick off Hockey Week here in the United States, today is officially Salute to Players Day. So I'm just going to start here. For you, who was your biggest inspiration in hockey?
Cammy Granato. Being from right outside of Chicago, I think watching Cammy grow up and really be a pioneer of the women's game has just been incredible. So with everything that she's done and everything that she continues to do to grow the sport is great.
Megan, how would you assess Team USA's play in the rivalry series? Obviously, three close games, one controversial goal for a fellow American here. I should have counted. But anyhow, what would you say about it?
It's great. We've never actually done a series like this in mid-February. So any time that we can play games, especially against our biggest rival, it is great. So just to showcase the sport, and with everything going on around the NHL All-Star Game with the four girls that attended there, it's just a great showcase of where women's hockey has come.
I would agree with that term, Megan. Showcase is exactly the term. And two teams that are really evenly matched. I had a chance to catch up with a few of your teammates in Detroit between Game 2 and Game 3. Kendall, Danny, and Gigi were kind of telling me about how things went for you in Game 2. Started a little flat and got into some penalty trouble. How do you evaluate Game 3? Again, a really close one.
Yeah, I think we did also get into penalty trouble at the beginning, but just kind of the way the game goes and figuring out our system, working out our systems, and really pushing forward to try different things before World Championships, because World Championships start at the beginning of April, and we know that we'll see the Canadians at least once in regulation. So it's just about fine-tuning things, focusing on those details, and working together as a team. This was the first time that this group had been together. So to take the first game was great. The second game was a close battle. We came back at the end, but that third game was also a battle until the end, again with a controversial goal call that obviously we'd love that.
It wouldn't be Canada versus the U.S. without a little drama, right?
Always.
So, Megan, the landscape for women's professional hockey right now kind of straddles the Canada-U.S. border. The Canadian Women's Hockey League north of the border, the American certainly south of the border. How do you contrast the two? Are they fairly similar, just the caliber of play?
Absolutely. Within our two professional leagues comes obviously some great players, and specifically in the U.S., it's actually incredible. We're told some statistics that about 30 years ago we had 3,500 female hockey players, and in 2017-2018 the under 18 girls were over 60,000 players.
Wow.
So with the game constantly growing, and for us to continue to push to grow that game, it's just been great. So the United States is obviously growing. Canada, there's hockey every other block. So to have the two professional leagues is great, and I think it's really a push next step to really make that one league here.
Yeah, both of those leagues go a long way in promoting the women's game, as do any time we have a rivalry series or the Americans meeting the Canadians at the Olympics or on the world stage. You mentioned Kendall Coyne and some of the other ladies at the All-Star festivities this year. I grew up with a sister whose goal was to play in the NHL one day. I mean, that was her real dream. So that was a big moment for my family. For you, what was it like to see Kendall Coyne out there just kind of shocking the boys a little bit?
Amazing. And I think the expression on every single person's face that was on that ice told it all. You didn't know what to expect. And obviously us that play with her and the girls that play against her kind of knew. But to watch her go and, like she said, to break barriers is beyond anything that I would have imagined. So for her to really show what our sport is about, because obviously we don't have open ice hitting, but like you said, it's physical, it's the nitty gritty of the game, like you saw in game one. But with Kendall doing that, and then Brianna Decker technically winning that skills challenge herself, is just great. I think our sport has really taken off, and the viewers and fans got a treat of that at the NHL All-Star Game.
Yes, it is just trending up and up and up. Listen, Megan, we appreciate the time. The Rivalry Series was a blast to watch, lived up to all the hype. Thanks for this, and continued success.
Thank you very much.